Hello friends, welcome. Well, today's video is about, you know, do you fear dying and death? We have life preservation, don't we? And we spend our whole lives trying to survive and not be ill and avoid death, yes. And, you know, it's very instinctual to have self-preservation and avoid demise. So there's a natural fear of death, of course there is. The thing is that, you know, I've been around mediums and had so many messages from my loved ones that survived death. And, you know, they've come back with evidential proofs about things we shared together. My mother's in spirit, and she said so many things that we did as kids that I knew she was still alive and well in spirit. And my grandfather used to be around me quite often when I was going to see the mediums. And I got up one morning walking about my room, and I had already got dressed, and I went and got a pair of socks out the drawer, sat down, put them on. I go, oh no, not another hole in my toe. And went to the spiritualist church, and the medium was up there giving messages to loved ones from spirit loved ones. And he came to me and said, I've got your grandfather here. He says she was complaining about the hole in your sock this morning, you know, the very same morning. So when we pass and cross over, a little part of us comes away as a spirit orb. So we can stay here, and those spirit orbs can see and watch us. They have two different states of mind, one in spirit, one here, so they can act independently of each other. And they're around us at times. They don't intrude on us, but they come in with us when we're about, because they greatly care for us, don't they? So there are those that have had near-death experiences that come back and say, I went into some beautiful light and felt such tranquility and peace and love, and got told to come back, and they didn't want to come back. You know, but they did come back to their body because they were resuscitated. But they've, you know, partly passed over themselves. Some have even made it right through into the spirit realm, and a guide has come to them, or a being of light, and, you know, they've looked after them. They've gone on beautiful journeys in the spirit realm. Then they've been told to come back again when they've been resuscitated. And when we're at the end of life, you know, and we're slowly heading towards physical demise, that the spirit keeps popping out of body and floating around the room. And, you know, they say, oh, you know, don't worry about going now, because I've seen my loved ones waiting for me, and I've felt peace and tranquility and, you know, very welcome on the other side. So, you know, they do have experiences of out-of-body people that are near death. As soon as the physical body stops being able to support the physical life within us, the breathing or the heart or whatever it is, circulation, the spirit will come out of body, and it'll either sit up, or you'll find yourself standing by yourself, or coming out floating around the room, or sometimes going into the light and loved ones are there waiting for us. You know, our loved ones that are crossed over, maybe parents and different people like that. So there is no death. You know, the only life within us, there is no life without spirit. So a spark of spirit, if we've not had a past life, which many people, most people have not had a past life, at the present time anyway. So Father God took a part of his spirit and he blessed it to divide and subdivide and keep dividing and subdividing. Whether he speeds it up at times and slows it down, that how fast that happens, because it goes to 200 of his worlds that he's created. And all life, every life, everything that lives has spirit. So a plant, an animal, a fish, a bacteria, whatever it is, we all have that spark of divine spirit come within us. So when our mother and father, when our mother conceives, when the egg is fertilized, that's when the spark of spirit comes into that egg to give it life. So the only real life in us is a spiritual being. And we are spirits here upon this wealth, having a physical experience and life. So it animates our physical life, our spirit. And they're both very complementary to each other, because the spirit gives us life, and this physical semblance, body and stuff, gives us this physical form, mind, identity, different things, intelligence that spark of spirit didn't have. I mean, it's a life force. So it greatly gains from us, and we greatly gain from it. So it's complementary to one another. And it grows into us. And, you know, when we come out of body, we will be like we are when we die. We will have an etheric body exactly the same as this one, all the same memories, everything the same, identical. But the thing is, when we cross over, Father God puts anything to rights with us almost immediately. So if you've got a missing leg, you have it back. Or, you know, you've got missing teeth, you have them back. So he makes you whole and physically healthy. So any disabilities, you've got to be put to rights. So it's like me, I've got short-term memory loss. I won't have short-term memory loss in spirit. You go across, and once you've crossed over through this beautiful portal of light, a few minutes after your physical body ceases to function, your spirit will come out, and it's not a bad transition. Many are very glad to leave the pain of this life behind and go across and be free of that in the spirit realm. So, yeah, don't fear it. There is no death. So you go into the spirit realm, and your body rejuvenates back to your young 20s because that spirit is ageless. You don't have to eat and drink, but most do still eat and drink because they enjoy it. So you don't, you know, spirit is ageless in spirit. So even if you wanted to look older, you could ask to look older, but still everything inside is going to rejuvenate to a young age. So back to your prime of life again. And, you know, children will grow up to that sort of age and, you know, stop aging at the natural prime of life, which is, you know, early 20s, isn't it? So, yeah, we're all young and healthy in the spirit realm again. All physical things are wrong with us. You can still be troubled mentally. And, you know, the same person in the spirit realm as you are here, the next plane of spirit is familiar to this one. And even beyond that, that this is a world with physical things in it, and the spirit realm is in an etheric physical state, a spiritual physical state, whereby, you have everything there still. You know, they can make material things, cars or, you know, hi-fis or whatever it is you want. So, yeah, it's like that. And, you know, you're the same person as you were here. So if you've been dark down here, a criminal or something, you'd still be like that in the spirit realm. And hopefully in time you'd, you know, learn better and, you know, to do and live a better life and treat other people more fairly, of course. So you don't change that much. And some people say, well, when I cross over, will my loved ones still be there? Because there are different planes of evolution. Yes, they will still be on the next plane, most of them, for sure. And they can come back to any lower plane. It's like we can come back here at any time from the spirit realm through our light. They can come through their light back to any lower plane, including here. So we won't be kept apart from our loved ones. We'll be with them. Most of them, take hundreds of years before they can evolve to plane 3. So many years anyway. I mean, you can do it in a natural lifetime because the odd person even here that's very spiritual can make it to plane 3, but they can come back to plane 2 in this plane, which is called plane 1, because this is part of the spirit realm, the earth, because we're spiritual beings inside the physical host body. So this body's hosting our spirit, really, and helping it to come and be all these things that we are. So on the next plane, we enjoy many of the same things. And, you know, it's a better place. You know, you don't have to eat and drink, and there's no disease there and stuff like that. You can have mental issues. You might still have depression, things like this, but you can get over those things through helping yourself greatly. So, you know, the actual transition of dying is, you know, could be unpleasant for the odd person. Depends how they die, doesn't it? You know, it could be a painful death, but as soon as your spirit, your physical body can't support life, you pop out of body. So there is no death. You know what I mean? You're sort of going away, fading away in the physical life, and your spirit goes, whoop, out it comes, and you're alive still. So there is no death, and nothing to fear of death, because there is no death. You know, it's just a transitional stage from physical into spiritual, isn't it? That's all. So it's good, and people, you know, that come back in spirit are happy and greatly recovered and having good lives there. So nothing to fear at all. So people say they don't want to ever come back here, and you don't ever have to come back here. Reincarnation is a choice for spirit. They don't have to come back here. Nobody forces anything. It's free will in the spirit realm, just like it is here. If you don't want to return, you don't have to. But many spirit do and not a high proportion of the Earth's population is reincarnated, a small percentage at the moment, but many return, and they have to be very evolved souls, pretty evolved souls, before they can return, because they've got to be nothing but complementary to this new life, you see. If there was a bad, evil person, you wouldn't want that in you. So people like that are not progressed enough to come back. So they've worked off their karma, no past life karmic debt, there isn't. The past life has no effects on you, even if it has a predestined life plan. It's just put in the right life that will have all those experiences down here by natural events. So Father God, very, very carefully, you can ask for location or a town you want to. You've got to stay the same gender as what you were in the first life, but you can ask to go to a certain area or a certain town maybe on this world, and Father God will pick the most appropriate person in that area. So some people say, oh, my daughter, you know, I had a miscarriage and my daughter's child is that child. It's not, you know what I mean, it doesn't happen like that. It would be very confusing for that child when they get in the spirit realm, but they wouldn't be evolved enough to reincarnate in that time to be the, you know, child of the daughter. So that sort of thing really doesn't happen. It would be extremely rare if it ever did. So it's practicalities, isn't it? You know, we live by practicalities and different things. So don't fear death. There's nothing to fear. You're going to survive death. Proof of survival comes through many mediums and psychics and different people, or personally yourself. You can feel loved ones around you sometimes, like when you're going to sleep at night, sometimes they interact with you, or when you're sort of daydreaming at the sink, not really looking at anything, you're just traveling in your mind. That's perfect time for spirit to communicate with you, when the conscious mind goes to sleep more and your imagination's just roaming and journeying in its imaginations. Is a great time for spirit to interact in some way, energies around us, touching you on the shoulder, all sorts of things they do to get our attention, because they want us to know they're okay and they want to let us know they're around us. So that's just love, isn't it? So yes, very loving spirit. Anyway, you know, don't fear it. You know, put it out of your mind, the fear. It's going to be an easy transition. All those spirit that come back say, when I was going in and out of body before my body finally gave up and released me, that I was just hovering around the room or standing by the side of the bed, and I felt complete love and calmness and happiness, wasn't troubled in the slightest bit. So it's made as easy a transition as possible by Father God. And you can stay here once you've come out of body. Loved ones will come and greet you. If you don't want to cross over at that point, you don't have to. You can stay here with your loved ones, but they can't really notice you very much, but you want to be around them. But you're a spirit orb too down here straight away, so you can go to your own funeral. And the amount of spirit down at the church that come through to their loved ones, say, I was at the funeral and so and so, you know, gave me that, and I really like those flowers, and I like my bit of music being played. So yeah. Yeah, it's happy. So there's no real need to fear it. And you know, we fear those we've lost, and, you know, say, oh, are they still about? Are they still alive? Where are they? You know, are they gone forever? But they're not. You know, there's no death of any spirit. So from that point of conception, if that woman had reabsorbed that egg or had a miscarriage or whatever, that child is going to live on in the spirit realm, quite often be looked after by loved ones in the spirit realm or greatly cared for, and when they're old enough, they'll be brought here to be with their mother. So you know what I mean, so there's no separation like that. They can always be with us, no need to fear it, you know, and it's made as easy as possible, as I say. Anyway, that'll do for that. You know, don't live in fear of these things. It happens to us all, it's unavoidable, and it's made as easy as possible, and you'll be happy in the spirit realm. Anyway, bless you, friends. Love and light. Neil.